This past week was that day called Halloween, when the world finally had all the superheroes it needs, and then some. It is the one day of the year when no one cares how unusual or how colorful or how strange we look. It is the one time of year when we can all put on a mask and be whatever we want to be. In our day, of course, the costumes were simple, homemade, and cost almost nothing. Half the fun was making them and dreaming them up. Of course, the most common was a white sheet. Cut out a couple of holes for the eyes, and you had a little ghost running around. It was also amazing what a few minutes in a grandmother's clothes closet could produce. My favorite, though, was the Wild Man of Borneo, a chicken bone tied up in a nylon stocking for the head, a little burnt cork for grime, and a few dashes of lipstick for blood streaks, and no one would guess that underneath was actually a little blonde boy from South St. Louis. Nowadays, costumes have become more elaborate, more professional, ready-made, and much, much more expensive. Like everything else, and certainly like every other holiday, this one too has become commercialized to the extreme. In losing the simplicity, we have perhaps lost also some of the fun. And without a doubt, we have lost some of our ability to imagine, improvise, create. Why is it that people love to dress up? Why is it that we love to pretend to be someone we are not? There are people who do this constantly, professionally even, and these are known as actors. On the stage and on the screen, these remarkable men and women bring to life for us people who are not themselves and people who are not ourselves. Someone once asked an actor, "Isn't it difficult to play someone else?" And with amazing insight, the actor replied, "Oh no, it is far easier to play someone else than it is to play yourself." I think there is a great deal of truth in that. Sometimes we would all like to be more than what we are, and often we would love to be less than what we are. October 31st comes around. We don the cape and become the superhero, finally able to save the world as we have always wanted to. But it is not just on that day that we want to be something different. We are old and we want to be younger. We are young and want to be older. We are good and we want to be better. We are hardworking and we want to stop it for once and just have some fun. We are average looking and spend exorbitant amounts of money enhancing our appearance so that people will notice. We are beautiful or we are well known, and we just want to get behind an ugly mask or an ugly hat and hide from all the attention. There was once a short man, and like many a short man, he wished to be taller, just as many a very tall person wishes to be smaller. With the same creative human imagination that produced the white-sheeted ghost and the Wild Man of Borneo, this little fellow changed his stature in the only way he knew how. He climbed a tree. And for that one moment, for that one brief Halloween moment of pretending and improvising and being something different, he is able on this prop to be taller than the tallest of those he had always envied. It is glorious. It is wonderful to be something else. But the Christ sees him as he always sees, whether we think we are over his head in a treetop or hidden from view behind a mask. The Christ sees not the strange and ridiculous sight of a grown man in a tree. He sees Zacchaeus down to his very soul and despite the tree. And he calls to him, as he calls to us, by name, Zacchaeus, come down from that tree. Kevin, take off that mask. Sally, come out from that sheet. It is you I must stay with today. Not a nameless face in a tree or behind a mask or under a sheet. Not someone at random from the crowd and not someone you are not and not someone you wish you were. It is you, Zacchaeus, just as you are. Zacchaeus, the little fellow. Zacchaeus, the tax collector. Zacchaeus, the sinner. Zacchaeus, the despised one. Zacchaeus, the child of God. It is you I need to stay with. So just come down, come out, and be who you are. The tree is descended, the mask discarded. The man is revealed in all his littleness and all his sin and all his love. And so he discovers the salvation that is his. For truth, without mask and without prop, has visited him this day. Be yourself, says Oscar Wilde. Everyone else is already taken. On Halloween and in your life, enjoy the masquerade, but then strip off the mask and learn to love the face behind. Enjoy the view from your perch in the branches, but then climb down and love your littleness. For the Son of Man has come to seek what was lost in the trees, to save what was hidden in the mask.